April Burrell was a diligent student during her school and college days. The former high school valedictorian was studying accounting at the University of Maryland's Eastern Shore campus. Then, all of a sudden, things took a dramatic turn when April developed severe psychosis following a traumatic incident. She eventually got diagnosed with schizophrenia. Unfortunately, the physician or group of physicians who initially treated her did not take into account the fact that April also had an autoimmune disease called lupus. After the traumatic incident, April remained in a catatonic state for years. After nearly two decades, the catatonic April Burrell finally woke up.
What exactly is catatonia?
Catatonia is a clinical syndrome characterized by a distinct constellation of psychomotor disturbances, according to a study.
What happened to April Burrell during her catatonic phase?
During her catatonic phase, April Burrell could not recognize her own family members. She used to speak to herself about financial transactions. She was also unable to communicate or take care of herself. Mundane tasks like taking a shower now became impossible to accomplish.
What was wrong with the diagnosis?
The physician or physicians who treated her initially did not consider her autoimmune disease before diagnosing her with schizophrenia.
What's lupus, and why is it referred to as an autoimmune disease?
Lupus is a chronic autoimmune disease. An autoimmune disease is said to occur when the body's immune system mistakenly attacks its own healthy tissues, organs, and cells, instead of targeting foreign substances such as viruses and bacteria.
How did lupus affect April's brain?
The multidisciplinary team of global experts who treated April Burrell made a startling discovery. According to the team, April's body was producing antibodies that were damaging her brain's temporal lobes, brain regions implicated in psychosis and schizophrenia. More specifically, these antibodies were damaging the glutamate receptors.
How did April Burrell recover finally?
After her second and more meaningful diagnosis, April received the standard treatment for neuropsychiatric lupus for nearly 6 months. She started showing signs of recovery. Finally, in the year 2020, April was discharged from the psychiatric hospital and moved to a rehabilitation center.
What's the moral of the story?
Physicians need to be more diligent while diagnosing a disease or disorder. More importantly, patients and their families must make it a point to seek a second or even a third opinion for major diseases and disorders.
Subscribe to SciTech Vault for research that matters.